Hey, my kings and my queens, how you guys doing this lovely Friday? I hope everybody's out there safe and blessed and have a wonderful day. I just started a new account for Snapchat. This is my first time doing it. I don't really know too much about this app, but this is my Snapchat link, if that's what you call it. So if you guys want to sign up for my Snapchat, there it goes. Queen Red with two D's, and also bottom is Queen Red 318. So, because you guys can't really see it, but that's what it is. It's Queen Red with two D's, and also the bottom is Queen Red 318. So, if you guys want to sign up for my Snapchat, that's the information right there. Okay, this is a picture of Persuasion. This is a young lady that got into a physical altercation with Sydney Star. I believe that was yesterday or the day before yesterday. They said they was filming the final season. I believe they was in Atlanta, I'm not mistaken. But they've been having beefs all through the season and whatever. Also with Judy. So let me show you guys this one, like, quick, and I don't know how I'm going to incorporate it into.
It's great. No, I'm talking about the conversations that you were having behind her back.
Be honest. We already covered that.
No, but she just said that she
got... Be honest. Tell the girl. She's not.
So are we just talking only about the audio? This is the whole show?
Wait.
She mentioned it. Stop touching me.
No,
it's
no,
an issue.
No, this is
the whole show. Oh, bitch,
lucky you. You got car crashes on the couch, bitch. Stop. Get the fuck off me. You are a fucking weirdo. Like, what the fuck?
You got car crashes on the couch. You been talking shit since I got on the stage, bitch. Now, how you like how I feel like you
don't touch me.
You lucky I didn't bring the milk.
You're like a huge man. It's weird.
You lucky I didn't bring the milk.
Like,
at this moment right here where she said it's time to cause problems, and some people say that the altercation that she had with Persuasion, that's what she got because she normally knows that she still has a male counterpart, but she lived her life as a woman, and so they trying to say, you know, even though she was born a male and she taking hormone pills, she don't have a right to physically attack a woman. But the thing is this right here. If a woman knowingly knows that Sydney Star is a transgender woman, even though people are arguing and tempers are flying and, you know, words are being speared towards each direction, but you still know that this is a transgender woman, it's your choice if you want to have a physical altercation knowing that this is a transgender woman. So if a person that's born a woman and want to live a life as a man and they get into a physical altercation with a man and the man beats up the transgender man, then they're gonna say, oh, you know, that she was born a woman, you shouldn't did that, and you shouldn't did that, and what will not. So they should have the same thing where you shouldn't put your hand on a transgender woman, and a transgender woman shouldn't put their hands on a woman that was born actually a woman. So I just think that all this right here is so disrespectful, and it's very, that's very down and disgusting, because even though Sydney Star lives her life as a woman, she is over the top, she is dramatic, but she's still a transgender woman. So she shouldn't be trying to fight women that was born women because of the cliche and all the talks about you were still born a man. So you shouldn't put yourself into a position like that. And you see it right here in the caption when she says time to cause problems. So what kind of problems that where you was at, where you, when you took that picture, Houston, Texas, until right here, people trying to hold you back and stuff like that. So you not only showing up to somewhere in a space where there are women, born women, and you're trying to cause problems. So you put yourself into that situation where you just said it's time to cause problems. So if someone physically attack you or whatever, then that's on you, because you the one said this time to cause problems. So you showed up willingly to where you showed up to, wanting to have a problem with these women.
Sydney said she want her around, and the girls don't want to give her around, so they paying Sydney, and they keep locking her up. That's not fair. Don't do Sydney like that. Sydney, talk your shit, sis. Talk your shit, sis. They keep trying to get my girl Sydney alive. That's not fair. Don't do Sydney like that.
Sydney started arrested and going to jail for trying to assault a body. They had enough. She's going to jail. Have fun in jail with the boys.
Man, what that old folk making on her? That big man. Okay, man. Okay, I'm sorry. No, I didn't.
And the dude that's recording this, I do not know who he is or whatever. I'm just, you know, giving y'all the commissary. So he said that she had a round, and I guess they jumped her, and she wanted to get that one-on-one. But even though Sydney Starr is transgender, these women is not finna give you no one-on-one, baby girl, because first of all, you was born as a male, and even though you're taking hormones and you want to live your life as a female, it's still in the back of their heads and everybody else's head that you're okay. Even though you look like a woman, you have breasts and all that, they're gonna take you to a men's jail facility. They might take you to a women's facility too, but they when they unless you got your birth certificate and your ID, everything changed, but they still have a sticker, because I've seen a documentary where a person was living their life as a woman, got their birth certificate changed, their ID, everything changed, and you have to have your male counterpart not there anymore to actually get everything changed, unless you got a lot of money, because Bruce Jenner, Catherine, she still have her male counterpart, and she has all her stuff changed over her ID and her birth certificate and all that stuff as a woman, but she still live with her male counterpart. So the documentary that I watched was that I think it was in Canada, I believe, where they give the person everything changed. It was transferred over to the name that the woman was living by at that moment, only because she had the female counterpart, everything else as a woman. But if she still had the male counterpart, they were not going to do it, because she still had the male counterpart, so she can live her life as a woman or a man. So they didn't grant her friend her birth certificate and everything changed over until she had the surgery to get a female counterpart. So with Sydney Starr, I guess it was in Texas, I believe. I'm not sure. They're going to take you to a male facility. They're going to put you in protected custody because you are obviously a woman, living your life as a woman, but you still have your male counterpart. So when they do search her, they're going to see that even she's on the internet for 5 years, they still have to search her. So she feel uncomfortable. They're going to get a woman that works there, you know, to, you know, she feel uncomfortable, I'm assuming, you know, because, you know, that is kind of embarrassing. You living your life as a woman and you still have your male counterpart. So when they go to jail and they search you and all that kind of stuff, that is embarrassing. But she put herself in that situation with the other women because she is young. She is a hothead. She's over the top. That's how some, you know, transgender women are. They are very over the top. That's for me, seeing it personally, like being out and on the scene with my friends. So I just wish Sydney Starr the best of luck in life. I hope everything worked out for her. But like I said, when a dude said that she's trying to get her one, they not gonna give you no one, girl, because first of all, you are still a transgender man wanting to be a transgender woman.
Don't do Sydney like that. Sydney, talk your shit, sis. Talk your shit, sis. my girl Cindy in line. That's not fair. Don't do Cindy like that.
Cindy started arrested and going to jail for trying to assault a battery. They had enough. She's going to jail.
Oh, now she on the floor again.
You ain't stupid, huh? She on the floor
again. Now she on the floor again.
Was she fighting with Natalie Lyon? They said she was fighting with Persuasion. Because that's what's Persuasion over there. And they all, them two out there got their shoes off. And she told me you was my friend. What? She get into a fight with Natalie Lyon? Let me have to, child. I'm going to have to get some more information on this, boo-boo. Because was she fighting? Was she fighting with Natalie? Because right here she got on some, right there she got on a different color outfit. When she got arrested, she had on yellow pants. And I was gonna play this right here, but that's when Judy was talking shit about Sydney Starr, talking about she still have a penis and all that kind of stuff. And then Natalie Lyon was like, you shouldn't be saying that and all the other kind of stuff. And then that's when Judy said, well, she showed me her penis and stuff like that, and I'm gonna be her friend. And she showed me her penis unwantingly or whatever. And I was like, yeah, you probably my friend and whatever, you know, we don't like each other, but we like each other, you know what I'm saying? We like each other, but we don't like each other. And you trying to show me your penis and stuff like that, because you know how some females say, suck my D, even though they don't got a D. So, by Sydney Starr being a transgender, she still have her D, so she's a woman dressed in women's clothing, and, you know, transgender, she says, so suck my D. She literally says, suck my D, because she still has her D. Okay, but moving on. But baby, that's not, she was, oh, child, I'm confused. She said something about going on tour and you put my friend and you shaded me and you was talking about me, and then Natalie Lyon come out with, bitch, you threatened me and stuff like that. So did they fuck her out of going on tour, the baddies tour? I don't know. I don't be following these bitches around like that. Especially Natalie Lyon, none with her long chin ass. But anyways, she thinks she runs from where on the curve is that she got into it with the dude from Zeus Network, the owner. Yes, sir. She was talking too much shit on this shit right here. And I guess she fired because she act like she run Zeus Network. And so they like, maybe her time is up. We don't know. We don't know, girls. I'm trying to look at the office to see who was that with that big ass. Okay, let me see. I gotta do some investigation. Gotta do it. So it looked like the girl with the curly weave, right? Her. Is that Persuasion? That's who she got into a physical altercation. That looked like her right there. Hold on. Mm. Yep, that was her right there. Yep. So that's who she got into it with right there. Her, the girl right there, that's who she got into it with. But it didn't look like they was jumping her. You know, we can't even play stuff like that on here. So, yeah, y'all. That's something else. But, Okay. Job. The streets. And what she thought she was doing with three security guards or three police officers. What did she think she was going? What she thought she was doing?
They keep trying to get my girl Sydney alive. That's not fair. Don't do Sydney like that.
Sydney started arrested and going to jail for trying to assault a body. They had enough. She's going to jail.
See, she got a different color outfit on.
Have fun in jail.
So she must have came back twice or something. I don't know, you guys. This is like not confusing, but confusing. Yeah. So she must have showed up that day and got you know, tapped, touched, whatever, and then came back again for, you know, the round tour for that fade. And they was like, nah, girl, we filming over here or whatever, and you're not welcome. So security. But still, all this right here is a hot ass mess. I wish Sydney Starr the best in life. And all that she do, because she is a very beautiful girl, and if she just calm down a little bit of what she doing, she can make it really far in life, because she already done been featured on a lot of different TV shows. I mean, like big TV shows. She was on Empire. She was on that one movie. The TV show with Brandy and Queen Latifah. I cannot think of the name of that damn movie or that TV show. But yeah, she also was on that TV show. She also had did some other productions and stuff. But she been dipping and dabbing in the, you know, the industry with the TV stuff. So she been doing her thing in these streets. But you know, then she also been loving hip hop, that ratchet ass shit. But still, she is very beautiful. She got that voice like a woman. She got that soft features of a woman. She's not over dramatic with, you know, the big ass booty and the big ass titties, you know how, and the big ass lips, you know, like, you know how some of these bitches be looking like fucking ducks. So she not over the top. So her features is more blended with her skin, you know. It's like I said, it's not over the top. She ain't got no duck ass lips. She ain't got the big ass fucking water balloon cheeks. Her titties ain't past her motherfucking throat, and her ass ain't sticking out past Memphis. Looking like I said, she don't look like a duck. She looks like a cornbread fed African American female, you know. So I would think that she would go farther in life if she would just tone down with the antics, the over, the dramatics, the flamboyant gay male, but she is a woman. So if they physically assaulted her first, I believe that they should be locked the fuck up. Maybe because he is still transitioning and he still is a man with a counterpart. That's why he was arrested, because, you know, men are not allowed to physically attack a woman, even though if a woman physically attack a man first. And I think that shit is totally not acceptable. But still, that's what I'm thinking. That's my personal opinion. That since Sydney Starr still has the male counterpart, that's why Sydney Starr was arrested. I don't know. I haven't reached out to anyone. I'm just going by what I see here. And they haven't had too much. So I haven't put up that arrest record to see what was her charges. I'm just giving y'all this content. I might jump on here later on. you guys. So I'm finna get on up out of here. This is your girl Queen C18 Regulated D-House Queen CV. If you like this content, go ahead and thumbs up so it keeps me in the algorithm. If you're here for the first time, welcome. Hey y'all. So also, if you enjoy what you see, come on now. Subscribe to the family. Notification bell button so you will get my notification every time I upload, baby. Yeah, leave a comment in the comment sections so I will know what you think about this content. Yeah, so go ahead and do those for me. And also, when you over here, watch this content from the beginning to the end so you can give me my watch time hours. Yes, all that. And I love you guys. And love yourself and love who you with. Watch your 12, 3, 6, and your 9 on motherfucking time. Yes. Watch your 12, 3, 6, and your 9. So, go ahead and do those things for me. I really appreciate it. And I love you guys. I love you guys all. I thank you guys for rocking with your girl. Yes, honey. Yeah. Thank y'all for rocking with your girl. We in it. All right, you guys. Let me go. Get up out of here. I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your guys' day. I hope you guys have a safe and wonderful and blessed weekend. And just love yourself. Love yourself. In love with you, wait, in love with love you. I'm out this B.I.B. Keep it in mind, it'll get greater later.